we go. Cup of the morning. Jo, neu über das Wort. Nice. Yeah. The first place for now. A nice lap for 19. It's all about, yeah, it's the cup of the morning. It's all about keeping the rhythm. Touch that, look at that, minus 26. The seating is also of course there for improving the PB. This combination is so risky. I'm not first in 65, what the fuck. Now I need to beat my PB for one hour in the seeding. Nein! Yes, it's the same. Apart from the one fact that people already know the track. And come trained into the Cup of the Morning. And there are way less people playing it. So it is easier to reach the one. And it can even be easier to win. But it can also be way more difficult to win because people are trained. There are just less really good players, so if those few good players make a crash, then it could be really easy to win. And if those few good players come through, it's more difficult to win. And I did it again. I mean, I don't really know what I can expect from my father. I lost all my 2x lead there again. This light in the first turn, eh? I cannot bring it home twice in a row. 68, damn. But that was a really good lap. Especially first lap. No, that was a bad gear. Last try. Too bad. I could have done the safe way actually in this turn. It's decently fast enough. But it's not perfect, obviously. So the cutoff for Div 1 is over 2 seconds behind me. That is the difference between Cup of the Morning and Cup of the Day. Much less drivers, hence extremely big margins within a division. Thank you. I searched, by the way, for cuts on this map. The fuck? But I couldn't find any cut. Bad ideas like these here. Okay, that was actually pretty good. But I... would have needed to change one thing. I didn't take this CP that you can take like this, for example. And the ending is extremely precise. They jump over to the multi-lab, so it wouldn't really be rounds viable. And it wasn't even faster, I can tell you. I tried this line once and wasn't faster. Even though there are some open spots, the checkpoint placement is made in a way that it's actually not worth. Take a reroute. At least it looks like that. I didn't find anything. And there is some logic behind it. The rhythm that I was talking about. Now I have like no rhythm at all from one turn to the next. Yeah. Imagine he sent that to Shorty. It would have taken a while. Yeah, so the main issue is that this checkpoint... Also, there are many short sectors on normal way, but what is a bit long is this chicane section here, and also from this to this checkpoint to go around. But exactly between those two checkpoints, the inside is blocked off with walls. So this is something you cannot do. And then from this... far outside checkpoint, the question is really, if you don't want to do this chicane part, where else can you even go? Like, what other checkpoint would make any more sense? And you won't really find something. Of course I tried with the closest then, but yeah, it's not really better. You always, at every cut route attempt, there's one checkpoint that you left, that you lose, that is left over, that you still have to get, and that will cost you then the time that it won't work. What a close round. Yeah, it's difficult to play with the FPS here on the server. It's crazy difficult. Also, I'm a bit afraid of this teleport that I got in the end of the seeding before I switched to the new server. I hope it was just because of the server switch, but I see that I lost actually 438 frames in my stream. I don't know when that happened or if it was the same moment, but whenever I have a teleport, it's usually not the only teleport that I get. There are usually more happening. I hope this time not, because this knocks me out immediately. I would be a bit sad now that I put some effort into this. The legs, why are the legs so heavy on this map again? And on the Cup of the Day server especially. The game runs so unsmooth. You have to see. I first played the map a bit off stream. And it's super nice. So then I was still offline, but started my stream and I already have a bit more legs. Then I joined the seeding server while streaming this map and I got already a bit more legs, but now I'm on the knockout server and this is so bad. The legs are so heavy. Oh man. It got worse, 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 worse. Interestingly, Sabo Jr. with the best time in the seeding is struggling here to do the top times yet. Nobi is very consistent though. Interesting that so many people write nice time, because in the Cup of the Day yesterday evening, they were already driving these times. And in the final, the winner drove a 0.9, so he got even a sub. You would expect in the Cup of the Morning, when you have time to train the map, you would expect people to beat that, what people already did in the evening. But it was a decent lap, of course. I struggled to get to these times at first, until I then finally got some feeling for some of these parts. Do you mean a statistic? In percentage? Like how often the world record holder at the time of the Cup of the Morning then also wins Cup of the Morning? Depends of course first of all how often he plays. Because that doesn't even happen too often. Like, no Shadowquencer has the record, but it's not playing. And then the world record can of course still change until the evening. But yeah, such a statistic wouldn't exist. You have a statistics for Cup of the Day wins. You have a statistic for Cup of the Day plus rerun wins. So you can use the mathematic and then you know how many rerun wins there were. But it's not differing between Cup of the Morning and Cup of the Night. One track main I owe at least. And Track of the Day World Records? I don't even know where you find a statistic about that at the moment. Does anyone know? Because on Trackmania IO you don't have a statistic in that regard. There was something with a statistic, but long ago, that's already very long ago, 2 years ago at least, where we had some Track of the Day statistics. Sabo, there he is. He's just very inconsistent. Ah, Huhn. Okay. Nobi is out. The most consistent driver from the opponents gets dead last. Ah, no, not dead last. Interesting. Okay, but is knocked out. And exactly in that round, the most inconsistent driver gets a run through. Dexter has the most and he has also the biggest streak. I have to open the website later. But Dexter had once a streak of a full week Track of the Day World Records. The thing is, of course, he is extremely good, but he didn't really have full opponents all the time. Also, this was also a time where not many tried to beat him. Also, Scrappy did the streak at some point. Last year, I guess. I remember one of the tracks where he had record. and 89. Does this website only count, also the world records at the time when it was not track of the day anymore, when the next cup of the day started, or is it just showing world records and you can still beat them nowadays, like old world records, and it would change in the list, but that would be stupid. So I guess it's just who won the track of the day, kinda, right? Exactly, there was this project to beat all Riolu world records. I don't know if it also meant track of the day world records, but I guess. So, yeah. Yeah, that basically confirms it. Now it's about 2 seconds. Is staying in or going out? I was thinking about all my world records that I got on track of the days, but I'm surprised that it's the number 8. I thought it was more like 6, especially since this track of the day leaderboard probably doesn't even give me the world record on the map where the cheater was in front of me. No, because I got second behind the cheater, and I would be surprised if this leaderboard would be in first there. So if I already missed this record in the statistics, maybe, yeah, if that's the case, then I'm surprised to still reach 8. If you want to check it on the website, it was the 1st of February 2022. I think so. I think 1st of February 22. If I got a record there. Also, it was for sure 1st of the month. And I think it's that long ago already, which is crazy. So, there are three opponents. We have the Jan guy, we have the Sabo guy, we have the Cypher guy. Those three showed good pace. Oh wait, Mata is playing. Oh, Mata took a long time though. I didn't even realize him, because yeah, he's usually playing. So I should have expected him. But I've never seen him. The whole knockout. Mata, I have another opponent, because Mata is the type of player that still improves, of course. Well, he doesn't play these maps before Cup of the Morning. He's learning them, so there's still a chance that he's getting better now. Ah, okay, Huhn. Wait, Mata's out now, I didn't look. Did I jinx him? But no, exactly those three players. They can try low 48s, and a low 48 is possible to yeah, lose in one or two corners, and then you cannot drive it anymore. Scheiße. And Sabo Jr. behind me. This is the round that I needed. Do I understand correctly that you want to tell me any person that has within the 24-hour span once a world record on the track would get a point there? So per track then many different people have world record? That's how it sounded, at least, the way you wrote it. Oh, my third, I drive the whitest and safest lines in EOS. Drove a similar time in the last round, where I barely survived. So, Cypher out. So we lost Sabo Jr. and Cypher in those two rounds, and before that we lost Mata, so it's now only Jan. That showed that sick pace. Okay, I didn't look at in every single lap at the top time, so maybe someone else also drove fast already. But those guys were more often to be seen. Drive again the shittiest lines. It's lagging just a bit too much, man. Oh yeah, that's a good timer from Jan. Sick that I'm only driving 0.4, it felt much, much better. As, no, apart from this chicane section, which I really saved too hard at the moment. Dennis 07. It was surely a cut map. Okay, so I saved myself into the final, and now I need actually a good lap against the young guy. GG. Woohoo! Yeah, now he got the pressure. Actually, I didn't need a better lap than that. Helping my percentage of wins in reruns. Now I won lately on Shorty's map against Jan van Spijk, and now I won here against Jan. So Jan TM is next. Yeah.